It's a perfect jumping off point to ask you your top four in the rankings now that we've seen what the committee decided for week two.
Well, my top four right now are the same as the committee. But I was wrong last week because I thought they put Oregon ahead of Ohio State because they respected Oregon's head-to-head win over Ohio State, and they both still have the same record. I was wrong because they put Oregon in the right spot for the wrong reason. They used this win over Ohio State as a generic anonymous win to plug into the almighty spreadsheet. Well, we learned that they don't respect head-to-head beyond that because they put Michigan and Michigan State, two teams with the same record, Michigan State won head-to-head, and the Wolverines are ahead. And so the spreadsheet, garbage in, garbage out. I respect the committee, I really do, but I really hate the spreadsheet because I think that head-to-head among teams that have the same record and conference championships should be the high bar for everything else to overcome, and the spreadsheet has it opposite of that.
Well, Trevor, the thing that the committee has also been telling us is that, hey, winning all your games matters, and Oklahoma's sitting there at 8. But the one that I want to bring up is the team that's sitting there at 9 that no one's really talking about, and it's Notre Dame, because when you look at Notre Dame's resume, it gets better week by week by week. They've got a win over a Purdue team that just beat Michigan State. That's number 19 in the country now. They've got a win over a Wisconsin team that's number 18, that's won 5 straight games, and their lone loss is to number 5 Cincinnati. So common opponent with Michigan State. Michigan State loses, Notre Dame wins. And when you look at the resume overall, I think it's up there with just about anybody ahead of them until you get to the Cincinnati Bearcats at 5. So Notre Dame is the one to me that we're not really talking a lot about, but there's going to be a lot happening in front of them. Those Big Ten East teams still all have to play each other. Alabama and Georgia will play each other if Alabama takes care of things down the stretch. And so Notre Dame could be the team that sneaks close. I don't think they get in, but they may get very close to the top four of the college football playoff.
Roddy, coming out of nowhere, that little that curveball there. And Trevor, given your vitriol of the spreadsheet, I'm gonna guess you're not an Excel guy, right? You just no Excel for you.
Definitely
Trevor
a Google Sheets
is not
guy.
A
Trevor Google Sheets guy.
Yeah, number right. I feel like that's right.
Wendy, I take a number two
Listen,
pencil.
We'll take a look at
I break it in half and I watch the tape. That's it.
I know. I hear you. Old school.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.